What's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel, or if you are new to my channel, then welcome. My name is Sabrina Omarije here on YouTube, and if you are new to my channel and you enjoy this video, make sure to subscribe, that way you get notified every single time that I upload a new video. But today we are, as you can see by the title, we're doing a video all about Sephora, and I'm going to be talking about my experience, how to get hired, like tips on how to get hired, and I'm also going to share with you guys why I quit my job at Sephora. So I wrote notes because I'm gonna break it down into like different sections. So I'm first gonna talk about the basics about working at Sephora, and then I'm gonna talk about my experience in that as well. And then I'm gonna give you tips, and then at the end, I'm gonna talk about why I quit my job. So we're gonna start with the basics. And my job title at Sephora was a product consultant. A product consultant is basically like a regular employee, like you're there helping everybody on the floor, you're color matching, you're in fragrance, and you're in skincare. Now, I worked inside of a JCPenney, so a Sephora inside JCPenney, and that is different than a regular freestanding Sephora. I'm pretty sure the interview process is different, and you know, regular day-to-day operations is different. So for me, what I'm talking about in my experience is from a Sephora inside JCPenney. And in Sephora inside JCPenney, we were able to move around. So we were kind of zoned in a certain section, but most of the time we were just wherever people needed help. So it would be fragrance, skincare, and also color. So for me, I was able to get, like, you know, experience in all three plus the cash wrap. Now, a little bit about, not necessarily the pay, but commission. So we do not get commission at Sephora. You just work based off of, you know, your regular pay. You do get to bonus, you know, here and there if you guys do good in the store overall, but you cannot get commission and you cannot accept tips either. So you're literally just working off of your hourly wage, but I personally like that because it leaves little room for competition against your other, you know, co-workers, and you're not constantly bumping heads or trying to beat the other person or whatever. So I personally liked that. Of course, I mean, who wouldn't want to get tips? But at the same time, again, there's not a lot of like competition against one another. You also don't need a license to work there. You don't need to have schooling for like cosmetology or anything like that. And that's a common question that I get. Even when I have clients go into Sephora, like sometimes they'll be like, oh, do you need a license to work here? Or do you need to, you know, have experience? And I'm like, no, you can just apply even if you don't have like a ton of experience. Of course, knowing something about the industry and knowing or being familiar with it would be good, but you don't necessarily need like a certificate or anything. Sephora does have something called gratis, and everybody loves gratis. Gratis is basically when a educator goes to your store, they educate you on product or educate you on what's going on for that month. And when they go to educate you, you get gratis. So gratis is basically free product. It can be makeup, skincare, fragrance, hair care, all that good stuff. And it can be anything from like sample size stuff to full size stuff. You basically get that every single month. At least at our store, we got it just about every month because our trainer or educator would go once a month at least. Now with gratis, I feel like you do kind of have to compete in a sense, because you do have to hit certain numbers, which I'm going to talk about in a little bit, but you have to hit certain numbers at Sephora. So yes, it's fun to be playing in makeup all day, but at the same time, you do still have to sell and you do still have to hit numbers. And you are able to track how many, you know, surveys and so on and so forth each person gets. So that can also determine how much and what kind of gratis that you get. So some of the numbers that you have to hit. So credit applications, you have to sign people up or try to get people to apply for a JCPenney card. And depending on your store, you do have to have like a certain amount. I believe it's a week. If you've been wanting to build your credit, I do suggest maybe getting a JCPenney card, because you can use it inside of the Sephora and say JCPenney's. But that's definitely one thing you have to try to get the customers to apply for, is for a JCPenney card. You also want to make sure that everybody that comes across you at the cash wrap is at least signed up for a Beauty Insider card. A Beauty Insider card is a rewards program that Sephora has, and you accumulate points, and every dollar is a point. and then you use those points for perks. So you get free little like samples of makeup, deluxe samples. So you want to sign people up for that. You also have to get surveys. So you have to tell your clients like, hey, if you liked my service, I would love for you to take a survey for me. My manager gets to read it and we get to read the comments. There's a comment section in the survey. We do get to read the comments every morning and lets our manager know that we're doing our job. The thing that sucks about surveys is a lot of people don't take them. They're like, oh yeah, I'll take it for you. And then they go home and they forget, or they just don't even care. So that sucks, like trying to get your surveys up there, but you do have to get surveys. And then the last thing that they track is color IQ. And that's overall like for the store, they don't track you one by one, but you do have to try to scan people for color IQ. And color IQ, a lot of people don't know about either. So it's a machine that we have. And it takes 3 pictures of your skin and it lets you know what color you are in almost any foundation that we have in the store. And it also matches you to concealer and to lip color as well. So if you've been looking for like the perfect nude color, you can go into a Sephora, get color match for with the color IQ, and then they'll tell you what, according to the color IQ, what nude lipsticks match your skin tone. So we do have to scan stuff out for that as well. So like I said, even though it seems like we're just playing in makeup all day, we do still have to hit certain numbers. So uniform, you do obviously have to wear a uniform. So there are 2 different uniforms. There's the black uniform with the red on the sleeves and the red on the back. And it's like a little tunic dress. And then there's the all black uniform where you have a little bow and then you wear like the slacks and everything. At our store, I don't know if it varies at different stores, but at our store, the 2 different uniforms didn't really mean anything. We just wore whichever one we felt like wearing that day. Another part of your uniform is obviously your face. You do want to make sure you're wearing makeup, at least girls, you do have to wear makeup. You must be wearing some sort of complexion product. You have to be wearing a foundation or a BB cream or a tinted moisturizer or something. And then you also have to be wearing some sort of lip product. You have to, I think it's blush, and you have to be wearing at least 2 eyeshadows, eyeliner, mascara. So there are certain things you have to wear or things you have to meet in order for it to be considered like a uniform. So as I mentioned earlier, we did have somebody that went in once a month to train us. So let's say you're going in with no experience, you are going to be taught about products and you're going to be taught how to apply certain things and you're going to be taught all the sanitary stuff. So you don't have to worry about knowing literally everything because they do teach you there. And before I go into like how I got hired and my experience, you do have to be 18 years, at least 18 years old to apply or work at Sephora. Now going into like my experience and all that stuff, I did get asked like if I got fired or if I left because I couldn't do YouTube and Sephora. And I've heard that people like have left because of that, but for me personally, I didn't have an issue with that. Actually, when I first applied and when I went in with my resume, I actually mentioned that I had a YouTube channel to the person that I handed my resume to. And it wasn't an issue. It was actually a big part of, I feel like, why I got hired, because it was like, oh my gosh, you do YouTube. So I got hired end of October, beginning of November of 2015. So I was there for a year, like literally almost exactly a year. And I got hired for the holidays. And I do recommend that if you want to apply there, you apply before the holidays or before back to school. Going in and handing in your resume to somebody. So, well, not just to somebody, you want to give it to the manager. I gave mine to a manager. I didn't give it to the store manager. So if you want to really not take your chances, I would definitely give it to the store manager, but I gave it to, you know, just one of the other managers. So I would just hand it to the manager and be like, hey, I applied online, here's my resume. And you do want to apply online before you go in to give your resume, because they want to see that you're eager and that you really do want to work there and that you're prepared to work there. So apply before going in to give your resumes. But that's definitely a tip for you, is go in and give your resume, because that way they know you are really trying to work there. So when I applied, I got the call, I believe it was that same week, and they wanted me to go in for an interview. And I honestly couldn't believe it. It was a dream to work at Sephora, and I was like super, super, super excited. And so I went in for the interview, and it was a group interview, and a lot of the interviews are group interviews, so that's definitely something to prepare for. And group interviews seem like they would be easy, but at the same time, if you think about it, you're basically competing against the other people that are there. You have to one-up them all the time, and you have to try to say something better than the person before you. So yeah, mine was a group interview, and it was very hands-on. Like, the first thing we did was an activity testing our leadership skills and our listening skills, so on and so forth. And then we went on the sales floor and kind of role played, like if we were an employee at Sephora, like, what can I help you look for today? And do you want me to add this to your basket? Let's do a color IQ for you. And then after that, they called a certain number of people and they're like, okay, you guys have to follow us. And they told us, like, these people are gonna follow us and the rest of you are gonna stay in the room. And the us that were in the room, we were like, okay, does that mean they got the job? Like, what does this mean? We were so confused. But after they left, they called us into the office and they're like, okay, we're gonna do another small group interview. And there was only a few of us. I think it was like 3 or 4. And they were like, okay, we're gonna do another little group interview. She asked us stuff again, like one by one, like why we wanna work at Sephora, what we are gonna bring to the table. And then after that, she took us all back to the big room and called us in one by one. And then when she called us in one by one, that's when she asked us a few more questions and she told us whether or not we stayed. And from that day, there were a lot of people that were there to interview. And I believe it was only me and one other person that got the job. And I was just like, so excited. I couldn't even believe it. I was nervous. So as far as the interview process, I do suggest that you're, like, you know, into it and talkative, especially if you are doing hands-on stuff like we did. Also, I know, well, at least this is a tip that I recommend, because this is what I said and I feel like this is what the main thing that got me the job was. One of the questions she asked was, why do you want to work at Sephora and why do you love Sephora? And a lot of people, the answers were similar, like, oh, I love makeup and it's the perfect store for me because I have experience, or, you know, so on and so forth. Like, for me, my answer didn't really have anything to do with that. I literally said, like, yeah, I love makeup, but that's not necessarily why I'm here. I'm here because I know that Sephora is all about customer service, is all about catering to the client. And, you know, my experience and my love for makeup is just kind of like a bonus, kind of. So that, I feel like, was a big ding ding ding. Like, the manager was like, okay, like, I like that, because Sephora really is all about customer service and catering to the client. Yes, you do know, you do and you should know about the products and what you're applying to your client, but you want to build a connection with them. So don't just go in and be like, I love makeup, this is why I want to work here, because that's not the only thing that Sephora is about. Another thing, of course, you want to show your personality and show them, you know, that you really want to be there. One thing I recommend is going into the store frequently before you think you're going to apply and get to know the people that work there. That way, when you walk in, they're like, oh, hey, you're back. Like, you're always here. Like, what's up? And they get to know you. And then that way, when you apply, they'll recognize you and be like, okay, we know who this is and let's see what they're all about. I do also suggest going in, obviously, with makeup on. You want to make sure that you're looking your best because you are going to be representing their company. So go in, you know, nice and spiffy. Do go in dressed nicely, dressed professionally. They'll tell you to wear all black or they'll tell you to dress up professionally. If they don't tell you anything, I would just suggest going in all black, but dressed up. Don't go in, like, you know, a black tee and jeans. Those are basically a few of the tips that I have. I mean, it's really hard to give tips for how to get a job because obviously it varies store to store and manager to manager, but those are some of the things that I feel are, like, key. You also want to make sure to, like, know the history of Sephora and what Sephora is all about, because you might get asked. That's something that I definitely looked into before I went in, because you don't want to get asked, like, oh, who's the founder, who did this, or what is Sephora all about? And you're just like, oh, they're gonna be like, well, why do you want to work here? Like, you don't know anything about our store. So definitely look into the history. Go in with full face beat, not full face beat, but, you know, you want to go in with your makeup nicely done, brush your hair, make sure your clothes is clean, and be yourself. Have fun with it. I know it can be intimidating. Even as a customer, it's intimidating sometimes to walk into Sephora, but interviewing, like, your heart's gonna be like, but trust me, just relax and just be yourself. study what Sephora is about, and I feel like you'll be fine. Another thing I forgot to mention really quickly before I go into why I left Sephora. My past experience did help me as well, because I was a cashier manager at my previous job, which was Adidas. And so that helped me because it showed that I had leadership and that I was able to handle money and all that stuff. And the store that I worked for was very customer service oriented as well. So that really, really helped a ton. And I also got along with everybody there as well. So my experience, my retail experience working at Adidas really, really did help me. And even the person who interviewed me was like, yeah, like the manager you had before this, like, really taught you well because you're very well-rounded. And so I have to give props to my Adidas family because they did help me out a lot. So now I'm going to talk about the cons, or like the negative stuff that I had to face working at Sephora. Of course, there are pros and cons to basically anywhere that you work. So the first con that I have is that I didn't get gratis when I first started. I'm pretty sure there's like a certain amount of, you know, weeks or whatever that you have to be there before you can get gratis, or I don't even know if that's the case, honestly, but I didn't get gratis for a while. I wasn't being scheduled when they were doing the training, and if I was scheduled on those days, I was told that I couldn't get gratis because I was new. And I've watched a few other videos where people have said that they got gratis around when they first started. And it makes sense, because what if I don't have Sephora makeup at home, or if I'm not familiar with a lot of the makeup at Sephora, how am I supposed to try the product and let my clients know about whether or not I liked it and give my own personal opinion on the products? And with that being said, I've only gotten gratis, I feel like, a few times. Like, I can definitely count the amount of gratis I've gotten, like, on my hands. Like, I want to say 4 or 5 times that I got gratis, and I was there for a year. So when I did finally get gratis, it was like little stuff here and there. It was like little deluxe samples or samples and like one full size item, and it was like a fragrance or something. Like, it wasn't what a lot of other people were getting. Of course, we weren't going around saying like, oh, I got this, but it would come out like, oh, have you tried this? Like, we got it in gratis. And I'd be like, oh no, I haven't tried it, because I didn't get it in my gratis. And then for the next few gratises that I got, it was kind of like the same stuff. Like, it was little samples of like whatever they had left over, and they would just put it in there, and then they would add like a few new things. And most of the time it was like skincare stuff. I would get like lipstick here and there, or like a powder here and there, but as I mentioned, it wasn't like a huge deal for me, and I didn't really complain about it. I was just like, okay, it's free product, like, what the heck. And then another con is obviously the hours in retail are very shaky. For me, I worked weekends all the time when I first worked there. I kid you not, I want to say for like the first 3 months I worked every single Sunday. I didn't get not one Sunday off. If I did get a Sunday off, it's because I requested it off. Like, I'm not kidding, every Sunday. And Sunday is the only day that Chris has off of work. Like, it was crazy. So then I decided to request Sundays off in general, and I did get Sundays off here and there, but then we got a new manager, and then I had to get my Sundays up and running again. So I was working Sundays again, and it just was like, oh, like, I cannot do it. So that's one thing that sucked. I worked basically every Saturday, closed so many Fridays. And by the way, other people got hired around the same time that I did, and they were getting Sundays off here and there, and I was working literally every single Sunday. So like I said, I don't know what was going on with that either, but yeah, like, I definitely went into my calendar and I was looking, and I was like, Sunday. Like, I was scheduled so many Sundays. It was crazy. With all that being said, now I'm going to tell you guys why I quit my job at Sephora. And it's all for personal reasons. I'm not going to sit here and like bash Sephora. This is not like a bashing video at all. It was all for my own personal, yeah. So the reason why I left, the first reason is because of school. And if you guys don't know, I am a full-time university student, so, and I'm a senior, so this is my last year of college, so the courses are not 100, 200 level courses. I'm taking 400 level courses, and of course it's not as intense as graduate school, but it's still intense. So yeah, I have school going on. I also obviously have a YouTube channel, and my YouTube channel is literally my everything. I'm not kidding you guys. Like, you can ask anybody that knows me, like, my YouTube channel is literally my little baby. So I have this, and it is like up there as far as priorities go along with school. I'll be in class literally answering comments. Like, seriously, my YouTube channel is my everything. So I have my YouTube channel, and I love doing it. So I'm always filming videos, editing, so on and so forth, on top of writing papers, going to class, doing group projects, taking tests, exams, studying, that. And then I also have freelancing. So I do freelance here and there. I didn't do it as much because I worked on the weekends, but I do now. I'm doing it a lot more than I was when I was working at Sephora. But when I got the chance, I did freelance, and sometimes I would freelance and then I would go to Sephora and close. Like, I would work literally all day and then I would get home to edit. But then the last thing because of my family. Again, if you guys don't know, I did move out of my parents' house a few months ago, and it took a toll on me at first. I'm definitely not used to it. I wasn't used to it at the time, and I didn't realize how close I was to my family until I moved out. Like, I'm so close to them. I miss them like all the time. And I have two younger sisters. One of them is in eighth grade and the other one is a senior in high school. I really started to get frustrated, especially when like my mom would call me or text me and be like, hey, do you work tonight? Or my sister would be like, oh, are you going to my game or to this or to that? And I couldn't because I closed or worked midday every single Friday. When I was in high school, you know, my parents worked full time. They still work full time. My mom and my dad work full time. And you know, tias work, cousins have school, so I know what it feels like to look up at the stands and not see like a family member there, you know, at my track meets or at my volleyball games, or my parents went to my concerts. But yeah, I know what it feels like. So me being her older sister, I want to be there. And it's not as easy as just requesting days off, because that means I would have to request just about every single Friday off, and that's definitely not gonna happen. My sister is in band, so she has parades on Saturdays, and I wanna go to her parades, so I can't request every single Saturday off. So yeah, it's just, I didn't realize how much of a big deal it was for me until I went to her first game and until I went to her first parade. Like, I was literally like, I felt so emotional. I was like, oh my goodness, like, I can't believe how fast time flies. But yeah, that's another reason why I wanted to leave, because I just couldn't deal with it anymore. Like, working every single weekend, I didn't have time for my family, didn't have time for myself, didn't have time for Chris. I live with him, but that doesn't necessarily mean that we spend quality time together, because he gets home late from work, he gets here, we eat, I edit, I do homework. You know, it's like we don't get to spend genuine quality time with one another. So yeah, I just got to a point where honestly I was just fed up, and I called Chris one day 2 weeks ago, because this week was literally my last week at Sephora, so it's still here. But I called Chris 2 weeks ago, and I wasn't even crying when I called him, but as soon as I started talking to him, like, my throat got all crazy and I started just crying, because I was so overwhelmed. I had so many things going on, and I just called him and I was like, I don't know what to do. And he was like, look, you love your YouTube, right? And I was like, yes, like crying my eyes out. I was like, yeah. And he was like, okay, like, what are you debating on? Like, just do YouTube and focus on school. And that's something that did cross my mind, but I personally didn't feel like I was able to, because I have bills to pay. Unfortunately, I have bills to pay. And I was like, how Am I gonna quit my job and just do YouTube? Because right now I'm at like 70,000 subscribers, which to some it seems like a lot, but if to others, and if you look at other YouTube channels, it's not a lot, and it's definitely not something I can live off of. So when he told me that, I was like, shoot, this is something I really want to do, but I'm scared. Like, honestly, I was scared, and I'm still scared. I'm nervous because it's a big risk and I don't know what's gonna happen. But he was like, just go for it, and I'll do whatever I can do to support us, and you do whatever you can do to support us. Just grind it out and finish school and kick butt on your YouTube channel. So to me at that time, I was like, oh my goodness. Like, it felt so good to hear that from him. Yeah, that happened. Then I called my cousin, and she was like, she basically told me the same thing. She's like, why are you debating on it? Just do what you love. And she's like, successful people don't become successful by staying in their comfort zones. You have to take risks, and you have to be willing to put yourself out there and to struggle and to, you know, struggle and figure it out and get yourself up there. So hearing both of them, I was just like, you know what, I'm done. Like, literally that day I decided I'm quitting. I'm leaving my job at Sephora. And that day I put in my 2 weeks at Sephora, just like that. And I couldn't believe it, and I still can't believe it. It's just, I love doing this, you guys. I love doing filming, editing videos, and I love uploading. And it's just like, literally, I never would have thought that I would have quit my job to do YouTube, but that's what I'm doing. And like I said, my YouTube channel is not something I can solely rely on for income and stuff, but I'm taking that risk and I'm going for it, and we'll see where it takes us and how far we get to go. And I'm gonna work really hard on it. But yeah, that's why I quit my job at Sephora. And I'm pretty sure some people were expecting like some juicy stuff, some juicy details. But no, I mean, it's just all personal. It's all personal reasons. And I know there are people out there who are juggling a bunch of different things at once and are able to do so. But it's all different for everyone. I can't handle the same things other people can handle. And I mentioned in a video before, if you are not doing what you love to do, then why are you doing it? If you're going to work and you hate it, why are you going to work? So it was time to take my own advice, and it was time to just leave. But yeah, I can't believe it. I just hope I continue to have your guys' support. I've had so many people reach out to me, Snapchat me, email me, message me, comment, like, you know, how proud they are of where I've gotten. And it's all because of you. Seriously, like, I would not be here. I'm getting choked up, but I would not be here this far on my channel without every single one of you that's watching this video. I'm excited. I can't wait to dedicate myself to my YouTube channel, finish school, and just see where we go from here. I hope this video was some kind of helpful, and if I miss anything as far as working at Sephora, I feel like I was all over the place in this video. I mainly wanted to talk about like why I left my job there, because a lot of people were curious. But if I left anything out, just let me know in the comments and I'll definitely get back to you. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I love you guys, and I will see you all on my next video.